Hi everybody, I am the Creative Lady, and today I'm going to go over YouTube's Interactive Transcript feature. Many of you have seen the Interactive Transcript on YouTube videos, and you've also seen how bad it is. It is rare that you will find a transcript that matches what the content of the video is saying. So in order to make your video correct, you are going to have to upload your own transcript to your video. In order to do that, you are going to have to listen to your video and transcribe everything that you are saying in that video and save it as a .txt file. If you're using a Mac, you can use the TextEdit. If you're using a PC, Notepad or WordPad. Here's an example of a video that I wanted to go back and add the closed captions to. I am going to go up to the top of the video and choose the drop-down menu captions option. After choosing that, you are then going to be prompted to look for the video or look for the transcript that you have uploaded the caption file to. So just remember where you have stored your .txt file, and when you get to this bar to upload the caption or the transcript file, know where you put it so that you can attach it to the video. Once you have done that, you are going to click the button and choose the attachment. You are then brought back to this interface to add a little bit more information about your transcript. You can optionally add the track name if you choose to add the track name. There is a lot of different options in terms of language, English being the default language, but there are several others that you can choose from. I like to change the track name to my custom title of my video. I'm not exactly sure if that's only a local track name or if that does register with the search engine optimizations or helping you to be found by YouTube and Google in the search results. So I always like to have all the bases covered by entering the track title. Before you click the upload button, after you have selected the track name and the language, choose the transcript file as opposed to the caption file, because you don't have time codes for your caption file unless you do. And then go ahead and choose the upload button, because that is what you need to do. Now that after you have clicked that bar, you will see that it is processing, and quite naturally, depending upon how long your video is, will determine how long the processing time is going to be. A shorter video will have a shorter processing time, of course. Once it has finished processing, you will be given an option to now go and view your video on your page. So once you do that, you can go back up to the top of the video and view it on your page by clicking that button. Once you click the button, you will be brought to your video. Once you are at the video, scroll down and you will now see the icon for the interactive transcript is now active. I'm going to show you this demonstration that I was doing in order to add a caption, and you see that even though the video is muted right now, it does match what I was saying in the video, and that you want to have an accurate caption for several different reasons, but primarily you want it to match what the content of your video is, because just in case, it really does help you to get ratings or to get traffic to your YouTube channel. You want it to be for the terms that are actually relevant and in your video. So be sure to take advantage of actually transcribing your videos. And if you're not doing it now, try to go back and start. There are some reasons that you really want to upload your own custom transcript. Of course, the number one reason to upload your own custom transcript would be for the simple reason it is going to be correct. You want to have the correct transcript in your closed captioned video. Number two, closed caption is always for the hearing impaired to watch. And it's also good to help other people learn a new language if they are in a different country. People do use that also to help learn a second language. It may also help improve your search engine optimizations, which makes your video findable by YouTube and Google. Not exactly sure yet if it's going to lend over to other search engines, but definitely YouTube and Google. It should help improve your traffic and bring traffic to your video because it is going to be indexed now by Google and YouTube by the terms that you have. And it's also going to make us make shorter videos because if you're going to have to go back and listen to your video, you are definitely going to be encouraged to make a shorter video. Who wants to go back and transcribe 15 and 32 minutes worth of footage? Not me. So I hope this helps you guys better understand the transcript feature of YouTube. And I thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.